Hi there. It's November 20th and time for Proverbs 20. Let's jump over there and we'll get into it. Verse 1, good advice. Wine is a scorner and strong drink is noisy. any going astray is not wise. Okay, that's worded kind of strange there, huh? Let's read it over here. Wine is a mocker, and strong drink is a brawler. Whoever is intoxicated by it is not wise. Errors. Okay. Don't get drunk. Okay, you could say that. Don't get drunk, because you're gonna get hurt. Okay. Two, the fear of a king is a growl as of a young lion. He who is causing him to be wroth or angry is wronging his soul. Right. Don't provoke the king, all right? Three, an honor to a man is cessation from strife, and every fool intermeddleth. Okay, that's just kind of strange, huh? Keeping away from strife is an honor for a man, but any fool will quarrel. Okay, make more sense over there? Yes, it does. Yes, it does. Well done. Verse 4. Because of winter, the slothful ploweth not. He asketh in harvest, and there is nothing. Right. The sluggard does not plow after autumn, so he begs during harvest and has nothing. Right. Don't be lazy. 5. Counsel in the heart of man is deep water, and a man of understanding draweth it up. Now he was talking about men deep waters yesterday, wasn't he? Right? A plan in the heart of man is like deep water, but a man of understanding draws it out. Counsel, plan. Right. All right. Let's highlight that. Right. Sometimes the plans are down there, and it takes a professional, counselor, man of understanding to draw them out. Right? If you're having trouble, talk to somebody, okay? Certain people are very good at drawing that stuff up. Okay. 6, a multitude of men proclaim each his kindness, and a man of steadfastness who doth find. Right. Many a man proclaims his own loyalty, but who can find a trustworthy man? You never know until you're in trouble, right? And see who sticks around. That's usually the way it goes. 7, the righteous is walking habitually in his integrity. Oh, the happiness of his sons after him. Right. Habitually in his integrity. You like that? Become so good at your integrity that it becomes a habit. That's kind of cool. Right. And how blessed are his sons after him. All right. That's cool. Habitually in his integrity. 8, a king sitting on a throne of judgment is scattering with eyes of all evil. A good king, that is, right? 9, who saith, I have purified my heart, I have been cleansed from my sin? Question mark. Who can say that, right? As soon as you say that, you just sinned again, right? So, nobody can say that. 10, a stone and a stone, an ephah and an ephah, even both of them are an abomination to Jehovah. Wow, I have no idea what that means. Differing weights and differing measures, both of them are abominable to the Lord. Differing weights and differing measures. It doesn't really say that there. That's really strange, right? A stone and a stone. Needs to be a little clearer than, huh? That's not clear at all. 11, even by his actions, a youth maketh himself known, whether his work be pure or upright. Right. You could tell what kind of kids are just by watching them. Okay. You could tell whether they're good kids or bad kids just by watching them. Right. 12, a hearing ear and a seeing eye, Jehovah hath made even both of them. Right? God made everything. The hearing ear, the seeing eye. 13, love not sleep, lest thou become poor. Open thine eyes, be satisfied with bread. Right? Don't be lazy, don't love sleep, or you'll become poor. Right? Open your eyes, and you will be satisfied with bread. Work. Okay? Work. Says, yeah, and it says it up here, and you will be satisfied with food. bad saith the buyer, and going his way, he boasteth himself. Right. Many people, you know, like this. They're talking somebody down on something. Yeah, I don't think it's in very good shape, you know. I'll give you half what you're asking for, and then they go away and go, well, I got this great thing, and I really got this guy. I got it for the cheap. They do that a lot. It's kind of robbing somebody, you know, when you do that. Okay, 15. Sustenance gold and a multitude of rubies, yea, a precious vessel, are lips of knowledge. All right, got that? We highlighted that over here. It says a more precious thing is knowledge then. Right? Knowledge is more precious than gold and jewels. 16, take his garment when a stranger hath been surety, and for strangers pledge it. Right. Get a collateral. Don't co-sign for other people's loans, but if you do it, says get a collateral. Okay? Get a collateral. 17, sweet to a man is the bread of falsehood, and afterwards his mouth is filled with gravel. All right. You hear that a lot. It's filled with gravel, right? It doesn't settle well, right? If you steal something. 18, purposes by counsel thou dost establish, and with plans make thou war. Right. I was going to look over here. Prepare plans by consultation, right? Purposes by counsel thou dost establish, right? You need to plan stuff, okay? You need to plan stuff. 19, a revealer of secret counsels is the busybody, and for a deceiver with his lips make not thyself surety. Yeah, that's a mouthful, isn't it? What's that say over here? He who goes about as a slanderer reveals secrets, therefore do not associate with a gossip, right? This is a busybody. That's a gossip, okay? Revealer of secret counsels is the gossip. And for a deceiver with his lips, make not thyself surety. Do not hang around those kind of people. Right? Do not hang around gossips. 20. Whoso is vilifying his father and his mother, extinguished is his lamp in blackness of darkness. Vilifying. Are you vilifying your parents? That's horrible. Right. Curses, it says over here. 21, an inheritance gotten wrongly at first, even its latter end is not blessed. Got that? What's that say over here? It says gained hurriedly at the beginning will not be blessed in the end. Okay. It says wrongly. Okay. Anybody, you give somebody something really quick, a whole bunch of something they didn't work for, they're going to waste it, okay? They're going to waste it every time. Okay? Remember that when you're thinking about your kids. Okay? Trust accounts are wonderful things. Dole it out a little at a time. Do not say, I recompense Abel, but wait for Jehovah, and he delivereth thee. Right? Never say, I will get even. By getting even, you are as bad as the person that wronged you in the first place, right? That's God's job. 23, an abomination to Jehovah are a stone and a stone and a balance is of deceit. Again, it says a stone and a stone is differing weights. Okay, it says this all over Proverbs, cheating people, differing weights and measures and scales, all right? Making them think they are getting more than you're actually selling them by cheating them, right? God hates that. 24. From Jehovah God are the steps of man, and a man, how understandeth he his way? That's what we did over here. Man's steps are ordained by the Lord. How then can man understand his way? Right? That's why you pray daily, Lord, guide me. Right? 25. A snare to a man, he hath swallowed a holy thing, and after vows to make inquiry. Now that's worded very strange. I mean, I'm familiar with that verse. It's a trap for man to rashly say it is holy, and after the vows make inquiry. Right? And that's if you, you know, you make a vow. God, you get me out of this, and I'll give you 50% of my income forever, right? And then after God gets you out of it, then afterwards you're going, wait a minute, what did I promise? Okay? That's a snare. 26, a wise king scattering the wicked and turning and turneth back on them the wheel. That actually sounds gross over here, but yeah. A wise king winnows the wicked and drives the threshing wheel over them. Turns. Yeah. Gross, huh? 27, the breath of man is a lamp of Jehovah, searching all the inner parts of the heart. The breath of man, I bet it says spirit over here. The spirit of man is a lamp of the Lord, searching all the innermost parts of his being. That's why I say our human spirit is a lamp to the Lord. He uses to search our innermost being. Mm-hmm. Oh, there we are. 28, kindness and truth keep a king, and he hath supported by kindness his throne. Kindness and truth, loyalty and truth, it says here. I don't say kindness, probably, huh? Covenant loyalty. 26. Okay, we're down here, 28. Kindness and truth keep the king, right? Kindness and truth, right? 29, the beauty of a young man is their strength, and the honor of old men is gray hair, right? Got that? Got your gray hair? It's supposed to be honor, right? I'm old. My hair's not gray yet, but it's getting there. But I am no longer strong, that's for sure. 10:30, the bandages of a wound thou removest with the evil, also the plagues of the inner parts of the heart. Wow. Stripes that wound scour away evil, and strokes reach the innermost parts. Bandages of a wound thou removest with the evil. Stripes that wound scour away evil. Bandages of a wound thou removest with the evil. Also, the plagues of the inner parts of the heart. Strokes reach the innermost part. That's interesting the way they put that, huh? Right. Right. Something. Okay. Well, that's Proverbs 20. Okay, let's go over the highlights here. An honor to a man is cessation from strife. Every fool inner meddleth. Right. Stay away from that kind of stuff. Right. Keeping away from strife is an honor for a man, but any fool will quarrel. Much easier to understand over here, right? Keep away from strife. Okay, just don't. Some people love to run towards that stuff. And I don't understand that. Counsel in the heart of man is deep water, and a man of understanding draweth it up. Right? A plan in the heart of a man is like deep water, but a man of understanding draws it out. Plans, right? You want to find a man of understanding, right? You want to find somebody that just knows this stuff. Sometimes that's a counselor, sometimes it's a pastor. But they're trained, and they can dig down and find that stuff, okay? It's important to have somebody like that to talk to. Okay? And I just like this. Habitually in his integrity. The righteous is walking habitually in his integrity. Oh, the happiness of his sons after him. Right? If you believe in God and you walk that path and you walk that straight path with God and it becomes a habit, oh, the happiness of your kids after you. Right? I just like the way it says, habitually in his integrity. You highlighted 11, even by his actions, a youth maketh himself known, whether his work be pure or upright. Right, we can read that over here. It is by his deeds that a lad distinguishes himself if his conduct is pure and right. Right. You can watch kids. You can watch how they act around other kids, and you can tell what kind of kids they are. Right? Just by watching when they think you're not watching. It's important. Spy on your kids sometimes. 15, substance gold and a multitude of rubies, yea, a precious vessel, are lips of knowledge. Right. It says knowledge is more valuable than gold and rubies. Right? It's just that simple. Right? With knowledge comes everything else in wisdom. 19, we have a revealer of secret counsels is the gossip. Right? A gossip reveals secrets. And for a deceiver with his lips, make not thyself surety. Don't hang around people like that. Do not hang around gossips that tell other people's secrets. All right? It separates friends. It separates churches. And it's just, you don't want to hang around people like that. Very, very important. Verily, verily. 21, an inheritance gotten wrongly at first, even its latter end is not blessed. Quickly, okay? Too much, too soon, never lasts, okay? In the end, it never lasts. Well, as I say, if you have a goodly inheritance to leave to your children, a trust account is a good idea, all right? Instead of giving them $250,000, say, I will give you $50,000 a year for 5 years, right? And that will teach them to balance it, right? 25. A snare to a man is he hath swallowed a holy thing, and after vows making to make inquiry. Now that's confusing over there. We'll read it over here. It is a trap for a man to say rashly it is holy, and after the vows make inquiry. Right? You make promises to get out of trouble, and then afterwards those promises come due, and you're like, what did I do? Right? Happens. So, there you go. That's Proverbs 20 for November 20th. Stay tuned later today. We are in the last two chapters of Acts today, and we will finish Acts. Right? Paul and, you know, Acts was written by Paul. And then we'll move on to the epistles after that. But stay tuned for that. We're on day 325, I think. But otherwise, give us a like if you think about it. But until next time, we'll do it again. See you later.